Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Cradle Blind. I'm the RPG chick. Boop! We gotta go back to the second pavilion, which we've been to before, so at least we know exactly where to go. Now, while we go there, I just want to say, really enjoying the game so far, and they have this whole, like, I don't know, this whole valley here. I don't know how far you can go, but... Oh, I like that song. There's not much to do except running back and forth to here, at least so far. There's a lot of empty space. What I am wondering about... Oh, we can go... Wait! I can take this. Which... I'm already, like, halfway there. But it's more fun taking this. Alternately, we can just walk through the gate. The front gate, because... We... just broke through it. Jump. Thank you. Don't jump... Don't drop down there. No, don't get stuck. No, not liking. I can't jump up there? Sheesh. Alright. We go this way. Go. Now we're moving. How many times do I have to click the thing? I guess I gotta press the middle first to turn it on, I guess. Yeah, we broke through here. So I'm wondering who I am.
You wanted to know about the look screen. When you undergo a transfer, you put your palm over the palm of your future body and look into its eyes. It's like looking into a mirror.
Huh.
This part is crucial. The transfer can't happen without it. Then you're immersed into a kind of peculiar state where you see yourself from the side. On a signal, you push off with your palm and a mirror appears between you. And then you're alone again, in your new body.
Okay. That's what I have to press. If you move just a fraction up, it starts to read the text down there, which is strange because... That is down there. So yeah, I'm wondering who I am. We can hear our voice. At least, I'm assuming that's our actual voice. And not just us imagining it, that kind of thing. That's one. Keeping an eye out for those ink blot things. Is this it? This must be it. So Evie, or whatever her name is, has not seen us.
I see you. Opening.
How ironic. She says she sees me now. She has not seen us yet. I think we've been around here, but... I just love the view. I'm gonna fall down through these holes. So she hasn't seen us because she's... Her view screen, her look screen, actually, is not working. So she doesn't know what we look like. I think we're an artificial life form just like her. I don't think that we are... Anabish or whatever? I don't think we are who we think we are. Because we don't remember who we are. And it's gotta be for some reason, right? Why would we not remember who we are? So we're assuming we're Anabish because of the notes and stuff in the tent. But that could not be us, and those notes could be intended for somebody else. I'll get this again. I was wondering what we're in store for. More Minecraft type stuff, sort of. Oh, 30 pink cubes now. 30 pink cubes instead of blue. Hurl cubes. Use bombs to destroy gray blocks. Bombs. Apply a pink cube to a red one to make the bomb explode. Alright. Pink and red to destroy gray. I guess gray we can't get through or something like that. Alright. Hopefully I'm better at this now. If I fail, guys, I'm just gonna cut it out because that's boring to watch. So we need pink cubes. We need those. Those pink cubes. You'll only see me, you know. Oh, the thing, the water's all the way down there. Alright. So where's gray cubes? Before I guess the bombs are the red ones? Well, the bombs are... Wait. Pink and red make a bomb. Well, the red is the bomb and the pink makes it explode, either one. Alright, so... Now, I'm a little awkward with... Damn it. A little awkward with this because I can't rebind the keys and I'm not used to working with keys this way. Tried to do it, as you guys saw in the beginning of the video. Failed. It wouldn't let go. I just kept moving in a certain way. I kept crouching and I wouldn't stop crouching. It was ridiculous. There's one up there, isn't there? It's gonna explode. I think that thing appears in response to us collecting these. But anyway, we have a good star here. Oh, it didn't... Boom. Oh, it made gray instead. Yay! Ah, missed. So it blocks your path completely. Don't fall. I don't know if I can make that. That jump. Maybe. Yeah. So I know there's a way to get rid of those blocks. We just read about it, but... putting off on that for now. I don't know, There's one up there, isn't there? So I see it. Even though the reds, I'm assuming I can walk on those. Okay. Sounds kind of like a sad song, doesn't it? We can still get through here. Alright, I think we're done with this level. Oh, I removed it from myself. Oh, crap. No! Are you kidding? No! I'm doomed. Let me out! How do we do that? Oh, I did it again. Can I jump? I really thought I was just stuck in there, guys. So you can get out. That's, I figured that was game over. Cool. Do not trap me in here, damn you. Yeah, I was kind of panicked with that. Oh wait, no, no, get out. I'm gonna get stuck in it. No! Oh, I am stuck in it. Oh no, I can get out this way. Wow, that's annoying. That is rather annoying. The fact that you can get out of them is good. Makes it not that hard. Are we done with this level? I see the little lights, you know, that's the column. I was thinking it's some of those blocks that we need. Can I just drop down here? Yeah. Running, running! I guess we're kind of good at this now. Maybe this is just an easier one because you can get out. Although these things are coming more often. So I guess it's harder that way. Don't want that. There's one over here. I see one up there. Oh, it's done already. I'm done. Too late. Yay. That was easy. Now when we turn, we get another thing we need for her. That really was easy. I mean, I still had... Oh, that's her... Her look screen. Cool. I still have so many more blocks that I could have gotten. Alright, new task. Take the lens from Tabaha. Okay, we gotta meet him on the little train type thing. Now, what if I jump off instead of... I'm okay, right? I have the stuff.
Right. I told you about the mirror between you and your former body. So, the mirror is turned on at the exact moment when your former body loses its original's right. It is concealed to keep you from seeing your face as it's put to death.
Oh, wow.
The reason is that sometimes there are involuntary, mimicking contractions that resemble a smile. Obviously, that is something best left unseen.
True. I jumped far, did you see that? I hear you at the train. Coming to Baja. Coming to Baja. I'm coming. I have you pressed flowers. I want to take a look around his train because he's just going to drive off again next time. Like he did last time. Okay. Oh, it's from the... It's from the Cabrera Gardens. Almost looks like Cerebral Gardens, which would be cool as well. Institute of something neuro... Neurofield? Pretty cool looking. Howdy.
If you got a death wish, why would you go there?
I know what he means, but our character is not.
Where?
Oh, nowhere. Did you bring the flowers?
Yep.
Here you go.
Attaboy. Here is your lens. My word is my bond. I'm not even going to ask what you want with it. I don't know what's going on in your head today. And I don't want to know.
Okay.
Tabaha, what do you know about this amusement park?
Stay away from it if you know what's good for you. Why do you think it's been fenced off? Because you shouldn't go in there. Yeah. You'll be better off.
You must remember something. Tell me.
Think, man. I wasn't even around back then. There was an amusement park. And I guess someone must have exploded in there. Am I supposed to remember every explosion that ever happened?
Yes.
All I know is this damn poison-filled behemoth has been standing there for 20 years now. And nobody ever gave a crap. But suddenly you do. Why?
Why not?
I'm curious. It's just so... strange.
Sure it is. But why do you care? What are you after?
I want to know why kids were undergoing transfers.
If they were, then there was a reason for it. Why does that even surprise you? It's just your regular mirror transfer.
But Tabaha, they don't do transfers to kids.
To ordinary kids, they don't. These kids, they may not have been all that ordinary. I saw them once at an airport, with their teachers. I remember those kids standing there all pale and silent. It was forbidden to talk to them. So there.
Do I have a quest for him? I hope I get to pick this one after this at an airport. Where were they coming from?
At an airport? Where were they coming from?
From all over. They were being brought here from all corners of the world.
What's so special about these parts?
Damned if I know. There used to be some kind of station here. A polar station. They were researching something.
Polar?
I think that's what they called it. It didn't interest me in the slightest.
Okay, we've got this back.
Tabaha, I've got a request for you.
Let me guess. You want me to dig up everything there is to know about the Cabrera Garden. Am I right?
I feel like I'm gonna get seasick. I'll have to turn on autopilot.
Only what happened on the day of the explosion.
Jeez, Annabish. Won't you just forget about this damn garden? Fine, I'll look into it.
Okay, so I guess we are Annabish because he's calling us Annabish. Right?
Thanks, Tabaha.
All right, I've got a roll. Last thing I need is to rack up airs and lose my wits. You know how vulnerable I am to that stuff. I may look calm and collected, but I've got crazy energy and passion for life.
You look just plain odd. Those glasses and nose.
These glasses are one of a kind. You couldn't get them in your wildest dreams. But I got them at half price. That's because I'm a high roller, while you'll be chasing such luxuries all your life.
Oh, thanks. What a sweetie you are.
Please, don't forget about my request.
Give me that. You best to not forget. I'll get you. See if I don't. Laters. Install the lens and look screen on Eda. Okay. Will do, big buddy. Good buddy. Good pal of mine. I know who I'm talking to. So he knows us as Anubish. Still can't believe I messed up with the flowers. Flowers all over the place, and I'm wandering the countryside looking for flowers when there's flowers all over there. Oh! You're back! Didn't he leave? He flew away. I can't interact with you? Can I jump on you? I see I'm ruffling your feathers. Sorry. Anubish is a jerk.
Did you bring what I asked?
Help me understand something.
What?
No, nothing new. You know, we're missing escape out. Nope. Yeah, so he has to ask this. We can't just return. That's the thing that's missing here with these dialogue.
Whose eyes are on your look
sub
screen?
Trees.
Mine.
Got it.
Mine. Got it. See, and now it quits
did
out
you
automatically.
Bring what I asked?
We're gonna do this.
I did.
The look screen as well?
The look screen and the lens. Let's connect them.
Disconnect the broken look screen. The input is inside, right behind it. Install the lens first, and then my eyes.
And then your eyes.
That's mighty odd. Okay, this is the broken one. Start a fire. So wait. This is the eyes, and that's the look screen? Oh my. Okay, let's get that thing on really quickly. That's really disturbing. Stuff! Now look at me! She's pretty. Now what does it take to make your mouth move? Now you gonna talk to me?
Well?
No reply.
How's your vision? Is it working?
Yes. I just...
What?
Nothing. It's fine. My eyesight is back, thank you.
You need something else, I know.
What happened? Did you remember something?
Yes, actually, I did.
And?
I know now why I wasn't on that list.
Why weren't you?
I wasn't on staff. I would come to the Gerbera Garden with the kids and go back with the same group, meaning I wasn't a full-time employee. I merely accompanied the children.
Tabaha said those kids were accompanied by teachers.
Those weren't teachers. It was psychologists that accompanied them. I'm a children's psychologist.
Huh.
Why the need for a psychologist at an amusement park?
Enabish, this is not an amusement park at all.
You're no kidding.
Those kids didn't come here for entertainment. They were gravely ill and were brought here for treatment.
Oh.
The Gravera Garden was a clinic.
Well, that makes sense. Because I'm like, all this time I'm like, well, they put them in their bodies before they are, you know, old enough to make that choice. But it's preferable to them dying, right? So that actually makes sense.
What were they treated for?
Some kind of psychological disorder. Quite severe, often fatal.
Hmm.
But it's hard to say exactly what it was. I can't recall.
A fatal psychological disorder? I guess they would be destructive to themselves?
You mean the transfer was their therapy?
One part of it, yes. There was a whole set of measures. Body replacement was the final phase of the therapy. We also searched for parts and staged plays. They too were part of the treatment.
The cubes. I knew when I asked us.
And the cubes? Were they also part of the treatment?
The cubes, the flower beds, even the height of the pavilions. All were deliberate, mandatory elements of the same therapy. The Gerbera Garden was constructed specifically for those children. It was the only means of treating their illness, peculiar though it may have been.
I do want to ask about the plays, so I hope that option comes back as well.
The illness must have been peculiar to match.
It's still hard for me to imagine what it might have been, but those kids, they evoked more than just compassion. There was something else, some other complicated, ambiguous feeling.
Tabaha is right. Those kids were unusual.
Yes, and the amusement park was as well. Which means all arrivals had to be registered, myself included. I'll try to look for some kind of visitor's logbook or...
Or what?
Beep, beep, beep.
What is it?
My battery. It's nearly discharged.
Oh.
Bad news. I need you to make sense of all this.
In that case, Enabish, you'll need to play with those cubes some more.
Huh.
Sure thing, Eda. I'll play. Which pavilion?
A moment. Hands. Wrists. There, the fuel cell. 10th pavilion.
10th pavilion.
Help me understand something.
What?
You mentioned original's right. What is that?
That's a right to bear identity. When a new M-body is activated during a transfer, it is also bestowed original's right, thus acquiring an identity. At that very moment, the former body loses this right and is destroyed.
When a new M-body...
Destroyed? Why?
Not sure. Perhaps to ensure the two never communicate.
It would be mass confusion if they communicate, I think.
Why? What would happen if they communicate?
I can't be sure. That's a rare occurrence. I believe the consequences are rather strange. I don't know how to explain it.
So wait. When a new M-body is activated, the former body is destroyed. What if this is Enabish's former body? Or... Enabish is the former body. He was trying to do something with that helmet. And taking samples of his blood.
Got it.
10th pavilion. Eda's power source is discharged. Head to the Gerbera Garden and obtain a new battery. Search the 10th pavilion. Okay, thanks so much for watching, guys. Gonna cut it off here. This is a nice round episode. stay tuned for next time when we play with more cubes. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.